As the Supreme Court took up arguments last week in two high-profile cases looking at same-sex marriage, many users of Facebook, Twitter, and other forms of social media took to changing their profile pictures. What was behind that viral online campaign? We asked two journalists from the website Daily Download. Lauren Ashburn is the site's editor-in-chief. Howard Kurtz is Newsweek's Washington bureau chief and host of CNN's Reliable Sources. Welcome back to you both.
Thanks.
So, Howard, what was behind this? How did all this get started?
The Human Rights Campaign, which, of course, lobbies for same-sex marriage, put out this logo against the red backdrop, pink equal sign. And Facebook itself says that 2.7 million more people change their profile picture to adopt some form of this logo, people are pretty creative, than usual, and this amounted to 120% increase, and you won't be surprised to know that the most active people were around 30 years old.
And what's interesting also about this, Judy, is that this logo, the person who created this logo, said it exceeded her wildest expectations of being shared across the web.
So this started as the Supreme Court was having these arguments last Tuesday and Wednesday. Who was doing this?
Most of it, it was the younger generation, 30-year-olds, and 80% of 30-year-olds are on Facebook. But in addition to that, there were some really high-profile people who did it, including Martha Stewart. Martha Stewart, there was one that was put up. Here it is, a red velvet cake. And you can see that the icing on that is the equal signs. And there was also George Takei, the Star Trek fame, now soon to be Star Wars fame, wrote, "For those opposed to marriage equality," and instead of the two lines, he made it into a division symbol.
And other corporations were getting involved as well. I think the next one was Bud Light. And going with a creative aspect there, we see two beer cans. And you like the next one.
My favorite is this of the two corgis. It's such a cute picture. It was just done by an average person. And then Beyonce weighed in. And, she has a lot of heft in social media. She has 44 million followers. And what she did, instead of changing or making a symbol, she wrote, "If you like it, you should be able to put a ring on it." And that is, of course, a play.
Playing off of her song.
Of her popular song.
So, Howard, how often does something like this happen, where an organization, an advocacy organization, gets something going? And it was an issue getting a lot of news coverage last week, but how unusual was it that it just took off like this?
The way it spread like wildfire is pretty unusual, but in this age of social media, everyone is trying to do some version of this. What I think is interesting here is rather than just create a page and then you get a certain number of likes, the fact that people could adopt this and put their own twist on it, make it their own, do it and make it a little funny, is what contributed to its popularity.
In previous times, you have breast cancer and people turn things pink, right? You had Arab Spring and everybody would turn their profile picture. There was a piece that you could put over it that was green. And so everybody who was supporting what was happening there would turn their Facebook
profile
green.
Although there was such a tide of this that some people started to find it a little bit annoying or perhaps feel like it was trivializing the issue. But as a galvanizing tool, boy, it's hard to match these kinds of results.
Trivializing because some of them were silly or didn't, right. Made you not take it as seriously.
Yes, there were people who said, that we're reporting on, who said, why would you put corgis, there, lying upside down as something to talk about gay marriage rights? And so there were people who just thought it did. It minimalized this very important issue.
What does something like this accomplish? I mean, when that many people are saying they agree, yes, it's kind of a referendum on what some in the public are thinking, Howard, but What does it do for the movement? I mean, do we know?
Well, since the issue that galvanized this is the Supreme Court taking this pair of cases, I don't know that it's going to change any five justices' opinions.
Although there was a very funny cartoon that said, was Justice Kennedy saying, "Can we rule yet? Well, have we checked in with Facebook?"
Right.
We have to check in and see who worked on Facebook.
And it does have the potential, I think, to turn off or alienate people who are on the other side of this issue, who don't support same-sex marriage. And there's, even though the polls show now 58% in a Washington Post survey supporting same-sex marriage, there's still a lot of people in a lot of states that are opposed to it. But it raises the visibility, I think, in a way that we haven't seen and probably energizes those who feel like this is the moment that gay marriage is finally getting cultural acceptance.
What about those on the other side of this issue who don't think that same-sex marriage should be
legalized? We did some research into that, and the comparisons are vast. The amount of momentum that gay rights advocates have on social media is 10 times that of anti-gay.
There was one page
that really we found on Facebook was a million stand for anti-gay marriage, and it only had 3,000 likes.
Is that that's reflective of the age of those who are using, which you both have been talking about.
Right. 80% of 30-year-olds are on social media. So I that's a very logical conclusion.
Could also reflect the fact that even Republicans who've been opposed to same-sex marriage have been pulling back or muting their opposition as it surges in popularity, which is in part because many younger people grew up thinking there's no problem with this.
And meanwhile, as Facebook is being used more and more as a political tool, we find the founder of Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg, has announced that he's going to himself get more involved in political issues. I heard his name connected with immigration
and education. He's forming a new political group. He has already hired lobbyists, both Republican and Democrat-leaning lobbyists, and he is interested in championing causes that benefit him, obviously. He would like more visas for skilled workers, so he has an incentive to really get involved in issues like this.
But Zuckerberg, who's a wealthy guy, is entitled to use his money any way he wants to push for any position that will help him or his company. But I do think there's a danger here. If he becomes associated with one side of divisive political issues, people who just want to use Facebook to check in with their friends and post pictures of their children might be turned off if it seems excessively political.
I don't know. CEO of Starbucks, Howard Schultz, came after an investor during a meeting. The investor didn't like the fact that he had supported gay rights, and he said to the investor, "I don't care." And I think people are still going to Starbucks.
It's an interesting question, though, because if so many people are using Facebook and then Zuckerberg is clearly associated with an issue on one side or another, it'll be interesting to see what the reaction is.
Exactly.
Howard Kurtz, Lauren Ashburn, thank you both.
Thank you.
You can weigh in online. Do you think these types of social media campaigns can influence change? Go to our website to be part of that conversation.